about the country, but actually the country comprised of many little people who are very important. Bangkok is not Thailand. Chiang Mai is Chiang Mai. Chiang Rai is Chiang Rai. And each little individual village has its own identity that comprise what we are here today. So therefore, allow me to share some thought about community-based tourism of our country and of our region, my dear friends, from Myanmar, from Cambodia, from Laos, from Vietnam. For Thailand, our strategy for tourism, even though we say that we have the figures, last year about 32.58 million international arrival, but we no longer count the head of the tourist any longer. For us, we only care for the revenue because we are aiming to be quality leisure destination. So we do hope that this year we will achieve about $80 billion. But what is more important is wealth distribution. If the rich continue to be richer and the poor continue to be poorer, I don't think we get nowhere. And so therefore, wealth distribution is important, as well as a social, meaning that we need to increase quality of life and strengthen community. And this is the duty of tourism that we can do. Most of all, environment. In the past, people say that to protect the forest is not our duty, but it is not like that any longer. Meaning that balance of sustainability must come from the forest, the water, the soil, the earth, even the garbage and the waste. These are all the duty that we need to take care. Meaning that our mission enhance quality of tourism product, develop tourism product to satisfy not only the market, but also the community. We need to learn to share. We need to learn to give. Effective tourism management, collaboration between local and government and human resource development. So for us, it's about people to people and heart to heart. This is very important for us. We don't want to say that tourism is economic. We need to generate certain revenue. But tourism is more than that. Tourism should not be based on how much profit we should make, but how much we can give. And we believe that tourism is people to people, heart to heart. So we, through tourism, people understand each other more. Peace and unity can be achieved by traveling. And I believe all of you here, I don't think you do it only because of profit. I believe you are in this tourism sector because you believe in it. You believe in it, as I do, as we do in Thailand. And we do it from our heart. We might be able to do some other thing with, and can be richer, with more profit. But we choose to be here because tourism gives more than money or gives something that money cannot buy. Friendship, understanding, and unity. I believe I'm saying on behalf of you all. Thailand, we are saying that we are approaching the digital era. Or not approaching, we are in the digital era. Thailand 4.0, sometimes people say we are no longer 4.0, we should say 6.0 or 10.0. I'm only 0.4. But whatever it is, the world changed with the social media and whatnot. But tourism, we have to remember that we have to keep our identity. Myanmar must be Myanmar. Thailand must be Thailand. Cambodia must be Cambodia. We join hands, but uphold who we are. And that is what tourism should be all about, now, past, or future. When we develop tourism in Thailand, we separate the area of tourism into cluster. The main town, surrounded by the secondary, smaller size of towns, and we have to make sure that once we get people to the main town, for example, like Chiang Mai, we have to care for Lampang, Lampoon, Chiang Rai, or Payao. So to make sure that wealth distribution can be created by tourism. And this is something that we have been doing all along. But as I have said, we are not going to stop only to the second town or third town. We are now going to touch more on the little community, the little village. When talking about wealth distribution, this is the pattern of Thailand. The spending in our country, accommodation is about 30%. Food and beverage is about 20%. And shopping is about 25%. These are important to us because when we say quality, it doesn't mean that we only care for the rich. We care for all sides of pocket. Whoever wants to come to Thailand, you are quality people. If we can give you true story of Thailand, the best thing that we can offer, you should be happy and return. And that is what we call quality tourism to us. We have to make sure you spend more money in Thailand. Spending per head per day gradually increase in Thailand. Length of stay gradually increase. Last year, average length of stay in Thailand is about 9 days, 9.5, 9.8 days. And spending per head per day also gradually increase. And so therefore, this is the thing why we are talking about gastronomy, because the more you eat, the more you enjoy, the more local people who benefit from this. So community-based tourism, based on the same, I have already said, we have to make sure that it is sustainable. It should be a sustainable growth, that community should get something. Tourism should get something. It should be responsible tourism. It has to be authentic. People can travel like a local. As I have said, people nowadays, they don't want to travel like a tourist. They want to be a friend of the local. So community-based tourism can give you that. Health concern, organic, spiritual meaning, work-life balance, very green and sustainable city. And CBT is the tool for the development. In the past, Thailand, we faced so many difficulties, especially in terms of politics, because of the big gap between the upper part and the lower part. And now, as I have said, tourism can play a big role and have been playing a big role to reduce the gap. So little village in the past, they might not be able to have big income. But nowadays, whatever they are doing, they can be the farmers, they can be doing something else. But they start to get additional income from tourism. And this is sharing. So in the past 20 years, we have been doing many things to promote community-based tourism. How can a community take advantage from tourism? And then at the same time, how can tourism give advantage to a community? It has to be win-win, sharing and giving. And TAT has been doing this and supporting this all along and trying to find the good model so that the other can follow. We have been giving out Guinery Award and to go along with the UN Sustainable Development Goal, that we want to make sure that the little village, when we grow them up, they should be able at one day to stand on their feet and be able to take care of themselves in the near future. I'm talking not only for Thailand. We have very many, many good examples in our very dear neighboring countries, Cambodia, here. Many, many of the good places, Laos as well. Myanmar, definitely, I was there. And actually, I'm learning a lot from Minister of Hotel and Tourism. I call him my big brother. Vietnam, definitely, many beautiful places. And I think all of us believe in the same thing, to give the chance to the little people. And because they will be the one who give out the authentic city, the local experience. So in the ASEAN country, we are now promoting more and more of the CBT. We learn from each other and we will grow together. For Thailand, last year, as I have said, in 2016, about 32.58 million international tourist arrival to our country. About 7.18 million are tourists that participate in ecotourism and CBT. This number, we believe, will continue to grow. At the moment in Thailand, the community-based tourism, we have about 264 communities. Okay. In the north, 82 communities, in the south, 63, in central part, 62, and in northeast, about 57. This is the thing that I want you to see, because I'm learning this from Myanmar, my big brother. How to collaborate the little village with the private sector. This is a new model that we want to make sure that once we start to promote them up, how to make sure that the tourism business can start to grow. And at the end of the day, private sector gets something. The village gets something. And the country gets something. So we are pairing the village with operator. You have to tell the minister that actually I'm learning from him now. So meaning that one tour operator, thank you for the association, you now work together with the little village. We are planning to create another 99, hopefully, another 99 community-based tourism so that they can stand on their feet very soon. They can make living by themselves. And then at the same time, we have more destination, more activities for tourist arrival to Thailand. Last year, 32.58 million coming to Thailand. 70% are repeaters. Will you continue to come to Thailand? Oh, thank you. We know that we need to create new destination. We know we need to create new activities. And definitely, a big part of that will be the community-based tourism. Because, as I have said, the new tourists, or the tourists in the very near future, you want to travel like a local. So you will become a friend of us in many new villages. And I do hope that the media, the buyers, all of you here, will be the best ambassador, not only for Thailand, but for ASEAN. There will be new local experience, new unique experience for you to send people from other places, from other destinations, to find a new home in this region. And I can guarantee to you that you will find happiness and true friendship. Because at the end of the day, to us, we believe tourism is about friendship creation. It's about heart to heart, and again, something that money cannot buy. The world can change, but we believe in ourselves. We believe that if we understand each other, we unite, No matter what happened, we will understand each other more, love each other more, give a better world to the young generation to follow. Through tourism, join hands, make this possible. Believe in tourism. Believe in people. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Your Excellency. Wow. Thank you so much. One thing that I'm really fascinated, I really fall in love with this lady is that every time she speaks is really touching. And I love that, I really mean that she is a really amazing woman. And this is their community-based tourism from the heart of the Minister of Tourism and Sports of the Kingdom of Thailand. Thank you once again. A big round of applause for Her Excellency, Mrs. Kobkarn Wattanavrangkul.